All right, so we're looking at the thigh bone or your femur, as you can see here. This is going to be the longest bone in the body. Now, dependent on height, it can be significantly long. And you can see in this particular individual, this is on the smaller side in terms of a femur. So in this particular view, we're looking at an anterior view. This is going to be superior, and the way that we know that is that you have your femoral head. So this is what's articulating with the acetabulum of your coxal bone to form that ball and socket joint. You have the shaft of your femur, or the body, and then the inferior portion here, you can see that almost the entirety of this is going to be smooth because you're going to have articulation with the condyles of the tibia, as well as on the anterior portion right here, you're going to have articulation with the patella or your kneecap. All right, so you always know that this is anterior for your patella here. So let's move back in terms of the structures for the superior ones down to the inferior. So I want you to recall when we were talking about the humeral head, how small it is in comparison to the femoral head. So you have a much better fit or better congruence between the femoral head and the acetabulum as in comparison to the humeral head and the glenoid fossa of the scapula. Now, if you continue, you can see a pinched-in area right here. We refer to this as the femoral neck. So if you've ever heard of the term a broken hip, it's typically right here that's actually being fractured. So it's the femoral neck that's actually the fractured area as opposed to the actual coxal bone. Now, on either side, you can see the two trochanters. The larger one that's going to be opposite to the humeral head, so we know we're talking lateral. This is your greater trochanter. And then more posteriorly placed, but also medially placed, you'll have your lesser trochanter. And we'll see this one again when we flip the femur over. Now, one other thing, we're moving all the way to the inferior portion. You have your medial and your lateral condyles of the femur. The way that you're going to know which one's which is that the medial is going to be on the same side as the femoral head. And we know the femoral head has to be medial in order to articulate with the coxal bone. Above each one of the condyles, you'll see these projections right here. These are referred to as epicondyles, your lateral epicondyle, and your medial epicondyle. And this is where your tibial and fibular collateral ligaments are going to attach. Now let's flip this over. Now we're looking at a posterior view, so superior, inferior. Here's the femoral head, the greater trochanter, and like I said before, you can see your lesser trochanter a little better here. So in terms of what's actually going to attach to these trochanters, you have a lot of muscles attaching on the greater trochanter. That's why it's larger than the lesser trochanter. All the lateral rotators of the hips, hip as well as your piriformis, which is probably the strongest in terms of your lateral rotators, as well as the gluteus medius and minimus, so those deeper and smaller muscles as opposed to the greater or the gluteus maximus. In terms of what's attaching to the lesser trochanter is going to be your iliopsoas muscle. And the iliopsoas muscle is a very powerful muscle, very important in terms of flexion of your hip joint. So lesser trochanter is going to be iliopsoas. Now, if you look at the shaft or the body of the femur, on the posterior side, it's going to be a bit more complex than on the anterior. You're going to have this line right here referred to as the linea aspera. And those adductors or adductors of the hip are all going to have an attachment here. So if you think about contracting those muscles, they're going to pull the thigh back towards the midline, so adduction. Now, we discussed these already in terms of the medial and the lateral condyle, but you can see these a little bit better here and how robust they are in comparison to the fairly shallow condyles of the tibia. So you have an incongruence here in terms of the knee joint. That's why you have all the surrounding muscles and ligaments that play such a big role in terms of the knee joint.